I want to talk about, well, listen, I want to get on the main line here. I want to talk about the weirdest Bible translation ever. See this right here? The Orthodox Jewish Bible. Now, why is it weird? Listen, how lost can you get if the truth is weird to you? You see, the truth, listen, let God's word be true and every man a liar. You go to New York, you go to Brooklyn, you go to a Jewish neighborhood, you see on Shabbos, no cars on the street, all the shops are closed. People are speaking something like Yiddish and English, Yinglish, you could call it. You say, yeah, well, that's kind of weird. No, friend, that's the way it was in the first century. Everybody who writes the so-called New Testament is an Orthodox Jew. And you have to see that you got to set your house in order here. And, you know, you're gonna die like Ahithophel. Or are you going to die like Hezekiah? How are you going to die? Are you going to leave this world believing a lie that the New Testament is a Goyish, a book written by the Goyim? Come on, now look at it just for a minute. Well, I want to talk to you about this Yiddish translation I'm doing right now. You see, here it is right here. We get to 2 Samuel chapter 18, and what's going on? The Ben David is hanging between heaven and earth from a tree. And he's alive, and yet he's being pierced. They will look upon me, whom they have pierced. Tav Kof Ayin, 2 Samuel 18. You got Dalet Kof Resh, Zechariah 12:10. You got all these words for pierce. You know, you get a colonoscopy. You're afraid your colon's going to be pierced by the instrument that the endocrinologist is using, and you don't want, you know, you can't be wounded there. You have to go back for surgery. He was wounded, het lamed lamed. He was wounded for our transgressions. Here you see Ben David hanging on the tree. Now in 2 Samuel 14:33, you have King David, and who is he kissing? He's kissing the son. Bar David, kiss the son, Bar, lest he be angry and you perish in the way. You got the Bar Enosh, the Bar David equals the Bar Enosh. You say, well, how could you make that leap? Listen, the Ben David called himself the Bar Enosh. I'll take his word for it and not yours. Listen, 2 Samuel 5:14. 1 Chronicles 3:5, Matthew 1:6-7, and Luke chapter 3, verse 31. Those scriptures show that when Nathan or Nathan and Shlomo or Solomon, the sons of David through Bathsheba, when they had their genealogies read out, one goes to Miriam bat David and one goes to Joseph bat David, and then we have Yeshua or Yehoshua Ben David, and here you have this runner, and what is he doing? He's running with the Besorah, the good news. Hallelujah. And David is mourning. He's weeping. Yes, they will look upon me whom they have pierced, and they will mourn for him. But the runner, the herald, is running. He's the Baal Besorah. And why is he running? In Isaiah 53, it says, Musar Shalomenu Alav. The chastisement that brought us peace was upon him. He was pierced. He was wounded for our transgressions, friends. Hallelujah. And so right here you see it. You see, we're going to put the Yiddish Bible all over the world, God willing. All with the Lord's help, we're going to put the Besuras HaGeolah all over the world. Now, Yiddish might seem weird to you. You might be so Goyish that you can't even read in Yiddish, even though you claim to be Jewish. But you know what? God is going to use the foolishness of this world to rebuke and to confound the wise. And you have to understand that the entire Bible is a work of Orthodox Jews. So an Orthodox Jewish Bible might seem weird to you, friend, but maybe you're weird. Maybe you need to get saved. Maybe you need to receive the Word of God and stop fighting it like Saul on the Damascus Road, who was the most orthodox of the orthodox. And I'm going to pray right now. Would you pray with me right now? Would you just bow your head right now, close your eyes, and say this prayer. Dear God, say it with me.
Dear God.
God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Thank you
for the Orthodox Jewish Bible.
That
I can find God.
That
I can hear the Word.
That
these Orthodox Jews who were martyred, who died, who wrote the Brit Hadashah with their blood, that their death will not be in vain, that I will receive the good news and give you all the glory for the Ben David pierced and hanging from the tree. 2 Samuel chapter 18, verses 9 to 14. And everybody said, Amen.